That could be a secret garden nobody knows about.
Do you have it as your volume?
We're going to take have a Young Gimp picture later, hopefully. So you're more than welcome to be in it. YouTube.
No viewers.
I'll take it.
Put it in my pocket. Put it in my back pocket.
You can take as many pictures as videos.
I'm swimming live. Check it out. Huh? What? Go ahead, put it in there.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, how are you?
Hey, how are you?
It's kind of pretty obvious.
I'm going to see you. Finally. Yes, you, buddy.
You know what it smells like?
What?
When you go to like the salon or
the
makeup
place. I'm late? I know, I had a quiz. I'm sorry.
That's what I was thinking. Or like a barber shop. I'm going to be good for
Oh, you're here.
Come on.
again. Yeah.
Well,
you don't have like a phone working.
Okay. Need to get more green.
40 hours.
I have money down here to get better stuff.
Yeah, I need to switch out the microphone.
Race. at the national level, the state level, and at the local level. But again, we have some wonderful candidates. With your help and with your support, we're going to win on November the 2nd. Now I'm going to ask you one more time. Are there any Democrats in the House? And my honor to introduce to you one of my colleagues that serves with me in the Texas Senate, and that's Texas Senator Leticia Vanderpool.
Thank you. course, being here in high school and graduating, looking forward to the future, whether you join our armed forces, head to community college, our universities, or technical schools, you have another responsibility. And that is to make sure that our government has leaders that work for you. That means you need to vote. A great deal of things to be thankful for. Our country, our schools, our neighborhood. And we want to thank today the great folks, the Board of Trustees, your superintendent right here at South Bend, and the principal, all the staff, who have made us feel so welcome, and to make sure that you get the opportunity to listen to a President of the United States.
At our young people.
They tell me, the sheriff. Sheriff, where did you graduate from? Where did you graduate from? Because they don't really do railroad. Okay. Now it's picture time. Go. We say history!
To make sure that they go out and they vote early. There's a There's a voting station right here in South Bend. We have an opportunity right after this rally to actually vote, to put that vote in the bank, to make sure that you make a difference in this election. While you're at it, I hope that you can make sure that you support pre-K for SA. It's a great investment in young people of our city, making sure that everyone in this community has the opportunity to get a great start in education. You know, a few weeks ago, I had the chance to speak at the Democratic National Convention. And I had the chance to talk about my grandmother, Victoria, and my mom, Rosie, and the opportunity that they helped create by working hard, the opportunity that Joaquin and I had to get a good education, to come back to San Antonio, and to reach our dreams. And to me, this entire election, and the candidates that we stand behind today, they stand for ensuring that the American dream is open for everyone to achieve. And one of those candidates is a guy that has been serving the west and the northwest sides of San Antonio in District 125 of the state legislature for almost a decade. A guy that's been a leader on issues of education, higher education, ensuring that we invest in all Texans. A guy that grew up in the west side of San Antonio, graduated from Jefferson High School, and has a resume a lot like mine. And a guy who looks just like me. So please help me welcome our next congressman for the 20th Congressional District, Joaquin Castro. Good afternoon. How's the south side of San Antonio doing today? I'm excited to be here with you. You know, Leon said that we look just exactly alike, but you guys can tell the main difference. I'm a lot better looking than my brother. I'm just kidding. He's 1 minute older. He's my older brother. We're excited because this is a special election season where we're going to re-elect President Barack Obama and Vice President. Represent the 23rd Congressional District. And so we're going to start the climb to turn Texas from a red state to a purple state and then a blue state. I want us to remember that there are three things that make America special in the world. The first is freedom. Are there any veterans in the House? Those who serve. We don't have to tell San Antonians about what it means to be free as a people. Freedom, democracy, the fact that all of us have the right to pick our leaders and to kick the ones out that we don't like, and opportunity. My brother, about a month and a half ago, had a chance, as he said, to tell the story of our grandmother, Victoria, who came to this country as an orphan and worked as a maid, a babysitter, and a cook, to do everything that she could to give my mom and to give us the best chance in life that we could have. But y'all here on the south side know that that story is not special to us. That is the story of many of our families. This election is about whether we're going to be a nation of people who are united in a common cause of preserving and advancing the American dream, or whether we're going to be a nation of people who just happen to live next to each other. The people on this stage today and the President of the United States believe that we need a country of opportunity, a country where the American dream is alive and well. And finally, it's a great honor for me to be representing, to seek to represent the 20th Congressional District. It was a district that Henry P. Gonzalez represented for many decades. About a dozen years now, and I promise you that if you elect me to Congress, I will work hard every single day to do everything I can for the people of the city that I love, my hometown of San Antonio. Now, I a very special person, somebody who, when I got into the legislature in 2003, was an incredible mentor to me and a mentor to so many of us Democrats. Somebody who understands that no matter whether you're a Republican or a Democrat, that you always have to put the people you represent above everything else. His name is Pete Gallego, and one of the I want to thank all of you all for being here. I want to thank in particular my friend Julian and Joaquin Castro, who have meant so much to me on this race. I want to tell you, my hometown is 6,000 people. My family had a restaurant in Alpine, Texas from 1917 to 1997 for 80 continuous years. And I have to tell you that I grew up washing dishes, being a waiter, cooking not so much because they wanted the people to come back to the restaurant. But it was, it's just a phenomenal feeling, I have to tell you. This really is a country of opportunity. I never would have dreamed in those days that I'd have the opportunity to be the Democratic nominee for Congress in the 23rd Congressional District. That all of us, every single one of us here, is here because of the sacrifices of our parents. My father, who went off to World War II and came back to change man and wanted to do what he could to make Alpine, Texas a better place, worked in the restaurant every day. My mother, who held down not only raising kids, but two outside jobs and worked in the restaurant as well. All of those sacrifices, just like the sacrifices of your family, your fathers and mothers, your grandparents, all of those experiences help make us who we are and help create that American dream. And as we talk about that, I want to take just a moment's liberty to introduce my mother, who is here with me, Elena Gallego, my fourth wife. The other thing that I will tell you is people ask me, well, you've been around for so long, how come you have all of this energy on you? And the truth is that this newfound energy is 8 years old. It's not a modern thing. 8 years old, which is still pretty young. But I will tell you what happened to me 8 years ago that changed my life forever in a way that made me want to go out and make sure that America tomorrow is stronger than the America today. Because 8 years ago, in fact, 8 years ago this month, I held for the very first time in my life, I held this really cool little seven ounce boy in my arms. And that moment is a moment I'm making. And that little 8-year-old, Nicolás Miguel, saluda, mijo, saluda. Here's the deal, this is what it's all about. This is why it's so important. If you think back, if every single one of you think back about what your grandparents did for a living, and think of the progress that we've made to now, we want to be able to look at our grandkids and have our grandkids have that same feeling, and be able to tell that same story of the American dream. That American dream has to be protected for all of our kids, and for all of our grandkids. And so, it's a land of opportunity. It's a land of opportunity. And we protect opportunity for our kids and our children. We protect it by providing quality education, by making sure that our economy is moving forward and providing jobs. We provide it by helping to take care of each other, friends and neighbors, colleagues and co-workers, all of us together, which reminds me, make sure you get all of your friends and colleagues and co-workers and your primos and your primas
vote, everybody has to go vote. Because I've never seen in all of the years that I've been in elected office and all the years that I've kind of grew up around politics and watching politics, I've never seen a starker difference between candidates than you see this November. It's an incredibly stark difference. So I want to tell you it's very important. And it's so important to me that I have, you know, that little kid growing up in a restaurant washing dishes in Alpine, Texas, would never thought that he'd have the opportunity to do what I'm about. I would never have thought, and I bet you that even my mother never dreamed, every mother dreams that their son is perfect, right? But she would never have dreamed that I would have the opportunity to do what I'm about to do. Because what I'm about to do is one of the singular privileges, one of the singular highlights of my career in public office. It is my great privilege and my great pleasure to introduce to all of you and my mom. The 42nd president.
Deal, the government would mess up a two-car parade, and God is on my side. When I register on your site, I don't want to get into a religious issue, but the Bible that I read said that the only time Jesus got really angry was when he had to run the money changers out of the temple. They always say they represent the original intent of the framers of the Constitution. They would be appalled by anybody trying to use any religious image to advance a particular candidate. Nobody owns the flag. Nobody owns love for America. The question is, who's right and who's wrong? Pete Gallego is right. You know, I think it's because he had a lot of real jobs. Because he did not only work at Quaker College, he was a prosecutor. And when you're a prosecutor, you have to win on the evidence. You can't win on ideology, you actually have to show proof. He helped to create a law to establish a DNA database so there would be proof, and innocent people would not go to jail, and guilty people would be proved. Is ideology more important than evidence? But in your life, the evidence matters, and you should